access to, well, my setup. So the audio is probably gonna sound worse than normal. Or maybe for some of you, here's a car. For some of you, you might think that the audio sounds, hey, just as bad as it normally does. To those of you, I say, and things like that than usual, because I don't have any sort of pop filter or anything to prevent the P's and T's sounding harsh. So be prepared for that. Video's not going to be super long because of this, but I am going to try to get something out to you guys, because last time I took a break, videos just went to the bottom of the trash heap. I've yet to recover. So, if you're watching this, I'd appreciate a like, subscribe, comment below. Really helps out. So, it is June, and that is Pride Month. So, we're gonna do 10 facts about Pride Month. If you have an issue with that, feel free to unsubscribe from me, because this is very inclusive community we have going on here on my channel. We do not tolerate unkindness. So if you cannot be kind, then I am 1000% okay with you unsubscribing. Did I say unfollow earlier? I meant unsubscribe. Or you can unfollow if you follow me on Instagram or whatever. Okay. Let's do it. Of course, I'm going to have the facts linked in the description, but you're not going to see them on the screen, unfortunately. I know some people like seeing that, Clarice, talking to you, because you like to read ahead or whatever the case may be, but unfortunately it's not going to work that way this time. But links in the description as per usual. Alright, fact number one. June is the month that commemorates the Stonewall Riots of June 1969. Stonewall Inn, a well-known gay club in Greenwich Village in New York City. This sparked a series of protests and violent clashes with various bars and neighborhoods in town, which served as a catalyst for gay rights movements across the world. Okay, I've heard of the Stonewall Riots. Some of you may have heard of them as well. That's where this stuff starts, right? This movement. Fact number two. Bisexual rights activist Brenda Howard is considered the mother of Pride, as she first coordinated Liberation March on Christopher Street on 28th June 1970. Exactly a year after the riot incident, she came up with the idea of a week-long Pride festival with parades, rallies, and dance parties, which has been kept since. Yeah, there's a big Pride parade that happens in June. You know, you want to support, go out to the Pride parade, right? There are Pride parades all over the world. Specifically in New York, there's a Pride parade because, you know, Stonewall Riots. We just read it. Well, I just read it this time. You didn't get to read it, unfortunately. Oh, here comes another car. This car is red when there's another car coming after. This one is black. I'm gonna wait. Okay, no, that car is turning. Okay. So, yeah. Alright. Fact number three. Wait, another car. We're gonna wait. Okay. Through the years, the Pride name has changed from the initial Gay Liberation March to Gay Freedom March, and with the equals life. Orange equals healing. Yellow equals sunlight. Green equals nature. Blue equals harmony. And violet equals spirit. Very nice. Can you hear the birds? There's some birds outside. Sounds very pleasant. Fact number 6. Baker also led the creation of a mile-long rainbow flag to celebrate the 25th anniversary of the Stonewall riots in 1994, which for a number of years became the world's largest flag. I mean, a mile-long flag. Is there a flag larger than that now? Good grief. Very large. Fact number 7. The Greek lambda symbol was commonly used as the symbol of the gay rights before the rainbow flag, as it was the sign of gay activists. I think there's supposed to be a the in here. As it was the sign of gay activists. Alliance. Oh, I just misread that. Let's do fact number 7 again. Fact number 7. The Greek lambda symbol was commonly used as the symbol of the gay rights before the rainbow flag, as it was the sign of gay activist alliance. Okay, well, GAA, I mean, that kind of, as an acronym, says gay. I guess it would be GA, gay, since it's two A's. I don't know. Cool. Oh, another car. This one is red as well. Alright. Fact number 8. The LGBT communities in Europe have been celebrating the pan-European EuroPride since 1992. It is hosted by a different city every year. This year the event took place in Vienna, and Thessaloniki will be the home for 2020. Oh, this list was done in 2019, clearly. I mean, you can Google where EuroPride is happening for 2022 for you. Fact number 9. South Africa is home to the only pride on the African continent and holds annual marches in Johannesburg and Cape Town. This video. Aside from pride, DYKE marches are also held in various cities around the world dedicated to lesbians. They usually take place on the eve of pride. They were first organized by Lesbian Avengers in New York City in 1993. I'm not gonna lie to you. When it said Lesbian Avengers, I immediately thought about Marvel. That might be kind of cool. Get a few lesbians together, they all have cool powers. Make a movie. I don't know, might be something. But that's it. Thank you so much for watching and or listening to this video. Here comes another car as I do the outro. As I mentioned earlier, this is not the norm, as regular viewers will know, but it is what it is. I'm trying to stay on schedule so that I can try to build back up. I had some good momentum going and then, boom, lost it, so we're going to build back up. We're not giving up. I appreciate everybody. Again, if you can leave a like on this video, I would really appreciate it. Hey, maybe I should start being a regular YouTuber and say, smash that like button. I mean, you can gently caress it as well. I don't mind. I'm sure it won't either. Alright, that's it.